Continuing from yesterday's aligning tutorial, I'll show you more ways to align, and introduce you to a must-have add-on called Edgeflow. Let's create a plane, tab, to go to edit mode, and control, R, to add a loop cut in the middle. 1, to vertex select, select the bottom vertices, and, G, and, Y, to move on the Y-axis while holding control, to snap to the grid. Do you remember how our aligned vertices were moved upward for some reason? If we were to type, S, Y, and 0 to align here. We can use the 3D cursor to have much better and clean alignment like this. Select the vertex to align, and Shift, S, to bring up the cursor menu. Choose Selection to Cursor. That seemed to have worked, but that's not the best method to align. Because that will only work on a 2D object like a plane. Before we proceed further, I need to mention something about good topology in 3D. If you can't find the teapot mesh, please activate an add-on called Extra Objects. Let's press Shift, D, to duplicate. Control, 3, to subdivide the first mesh. For the second mesh, let's poke faces and turn it into a triangular-faced mesh. If we subdivide this mesh, we'll immediately notice a random weirdness on the surface. Unless we're making a mesh to look like that, we need to make sure all our faces are quads. If they have less than 4 vertices or more than 4 faces, they won't subdivide well. The number of connected edges control how smooth subdivided surfaces are going to look like, so this matter is very important to follow. The triangular-faced meshes were widely used back in the 90s, when the video games were running on low-end machines. There are still developers and artists using triangular-faced meshes, but it's recommended to always keep the faces in quads. Let's create a cube, and Control, 3, to subdivide. Control, R, to add a loop cut, and move the loop upward. Let's add another loop and move it downward. How certain edges are closely arranged to one another directly controls how a subdivided mesh would look like. If we want a sharper edge in certain regions, then we'd need to add more edge loops. It's very important to place the edge loops evenly and correct for certain spots, otherwise the mesh would start to look odd. Let's go back to the align issue, and I'll explain why I have just demonstrated the edge issues. If we were to align the vertex in the middle to match the angle of other two on the same edge, that would normally take much efforts. Loop Tool's curve won't do anything here. Do you remember the 3D cursor align method I've shown you earlier? That will work well on a 2D mesh like this. What if our mesh was 3D? Let's try the 3D cursor align method once again. That's what happens in 3D, because we were moving two vertices instead of one. If we were to move the origin to the 3D cursor, and manually move the vertices to move in certain coordinates, that would work. Let's select the top and the bottom vertices, and move the 3D cursor there. In order for this method to work, we need to move the mesh's origin to 3D cursor. That worked, but look at how much time was spent to only align two vertices. There is an amazing add-on called Edgeflow, and that add-on is a must-have for all Blender users. It's not built into Blender, so we have to manually download and add it via Install feature under Add-ons menu. I'll post a link to the add-on's GitHub website. If you're having any difficulties in installing the add-on, please let me know via comments. Let's add multiple loop cuts on the cube and move the vertices to random locations. Wouldn't it be great if we were able to align the vertices from the top to the bottom vertices angle? In a straight line, and if we could do that with a single action, that would be awesome, wouldn't it? Select the vertices in the middle, Ctrl, E, and choose Set Flow. That was an add-on called Edge Flow. That did something, but that's not the result we were looking for, was it? Two rules when using this add-on. One is to always use it in edge selection mode, and another is always to select the entire edge loop. Tab, to go to edit mode, 2, to edge select, Shift, Alt, and click to select multiple edge loops like this. Ctrl, E, and set flow. Please edit the settings like this. We know how much time it took to align two vertices, and it's astonishing to learn how much time it took aligning 8 vertices. It will take that amount of time, if we were to align hundreds, or even thousands of edge loops the same way. That's the power of this add-on. Let's repeat the same process and see how fast we'll be able to align the vertices. Aligning in an angle from here to there. How cool is that? This add-on is amazing. But that's not all. Let's unhide the teapot mesh we created in the beginning. Alt-select this edge loop, and type G twice to edge slide. Let's add another loop cut and position it very close to the upper edge. As I have shown you previously, close loops would create potentially unwanted sharpness in the mesh. To fix that issue, select two edge loops in the middle, Ctrl, E, to set flow. Edgeflow just automatically evened out the selected edge loops to give us the smoothest result. Let's intentionally distort the mesh and see if Edgeflow would fix that. That was amazing. Edgeflow is a must-have add-on for all Blender users. This is the end of the tutorial. Please like and subscribe if you have enjoyed watching this tutorial. Thank you for watching.